Hello, my name is Anthony Hall, and in this tutorial I'm just going to show you the basics of using the Hot Ocean tutorial. So the first thing you need to do is download the Hot Ocean free plugin. I'll put a link in the description so you can get to that. Then what you need to do is go in your C drive, programs, find the NewTech folder, into Lightwave, support, and then plugins. And then you need to drop it into your plugins folder here. So if I just look up Hot Ocean there, look, Hot Ocean for Lightwave 64. So drop it in there and then open Lightwave up. So the first thing we're going to do is we need to create a ground plane with a load of polygons. So we'll draw out a ground plane, and let's make it 100 meters by 100 meters, and then we'll give it 100 segments on the X and 100 segments on the Y, like so. Okay, and then in the layers panel, let's just double click the layer, just call it water or ocean or whatever you want to call it. What we'll also do is we'll go to multiply and we'll triple. Oops. Triple so it chops them all in half. And then let's save it to our contents. So let me just save my, set up my contents folder to my desktop and into the folder I'm using. Okay, let's save it then. And we'll call it water one, and then let's send that through to layout. And then when we get in layout, let's go and go to the view tab, grid size, and let's just reduce this to, let's say, 1 meter. Okay, so what we've got is this here. Let's just move these lights out of the way for the time being, and I'll just put it on the in the viewport. I'm just going to put it on the Texas Shade solid wire so you can see this. Let's zoom out a little bit so we can see the whole thing. So onto the object, like so. So next bit we're going to do, there's a few ways you can use Hot Ocean. You can use it through the node editor, but I'm going to use it through objects, properties, and then add a modifier. And then scroll down to where you see Hot Ocean Toolkit, and by default, if you look, it'll add the default settings of the basic ripples and stuff, like so. Another thing you can do if you want is you can go up to IO and into the model option and then click on toggle subpatch, so that'll add the subpatch to it. Can also go into the scene editor and put smoothing on, like so. So if I just put VPR on, you'll see the actual Hot Ocean on its default settings with like the ocean moving about and the waves and so on. So like so, it's got no texture or anything, and it's got no like HDR lights or anything. So if we double click the setting, you come up with this. You've got the resolution, you've got the global scale, which you can increase and decrease depending on how big your ocean is and how big you want it to be. You've got the wave size, so you can make the waves more bigger and choppier or smaller depending on how angry you want you see. You've got the shorter waves, so you can control the little shorter waves in between. They've got the choppiness of the actual ocean as well that you can play around with. The wind speed, wind direction, you can all experiment with these when you install it. The wind direction, your damp reflections as well. And then you've got the depth of the ocean depending on how shallow or deep it is. It's up to you how you want it to be. And you can also save this out as a default as well. So, I mean, that is clearly the basics of once you've added it, you go and add your actual ocean settings and stuff. So I mean, if we set up a camera view. Let's go and bring our camera in. And let's pull it up. It looks like I'm actually animating it for some silly reason. Let's just get rid of that keyframe. Bring it back. So we've got our camera in a position here, so you can see the actual ocean waves. I mean, obviously you make this go off into the horizon so you don't get this kind of effect here. You can also just while we're actually doing this, we turn some of the settings down. So I'm just turning adaptive sampling off. Let's reduce these a little bit, like so. Let's add the GPU noise filter and then put it on faster for polygon interaction, so it will be a little bit better for clearing up and stuff a bit quicker. Other stuff you could do, I suppose, if you open up the actual surface editor, you could go to the presets. Let's go to liquid, just add the default water setting in here. Once you've added it, you can go in here and I don't know, change it a little bit, make a tint of green in it and stuff, and so on. And then obviously on top of this, if you wanted to, you could literally go into the texture for it. Let's add under the 3D textures, we could have basic turbulence, and let's plug that into a bump, and it will give you a finer kind of texture on top of it as well, which you can come in here and change if you want. Let's make it 5 meter, but you'll get a texture on top of the actual displacement map as well if you want, and so on. You can play about and add another texture, but that is literally the basics of installing Hot Ocean and just the basic settings for them, which again are under the modify settings, and so you can actually play around with each one of these settings. The Lightwave Guru did a few talks on this, and there's a few other tutorials that might help, so I'll put them in the description as well. But I just wanted to do a quick tutorial on how you install it and how you basically set up the basic options to get going with this and come up with some nice effects for the water. I mean, once you've added the clouds and you've put the water going off into a horizon, you'll get some nice results. So thanks for listening. Please share and subscribe, and check out my YouTube channel, Lightwave Salvation.